Okay, everyone, I'm here with Lzzy Hale. How you doing, Lzzy?
I'm doing great. Thank you so much for taking the time. I am so excited to come overseas again with our show, and we're headlining Wembley for the first time. I mean, we're just excited. We've begun rehearsals for this tour a couple days ago, and it felt like every sentence that we started with each other was like, "Can you believe we're doing this? Can you believe it's still happening? People are still coming to see the show," and we're just excited.
Yeah, it's amazing. I mean, Wembley Arena, your biggest show ever in your
Pretty
career.
much, yeah.
Yeah, and
It's
it's
a
fitting it's here in the UK as well because, the UK audiences have always welcomed Halestorm.
duh. Oh, always. And that's a rite of passage in itself, not just playing Wembley. That's a huge mile marker, in the Halestorm highway. There's a huge rite of passage for just being accepted in the UK rock community, because this is where our idols, were born, and the rock and roll that we grew up listening to comes from the UK. And so just the fact that from the very first time that we were ever touring in the UK, opening up like the first of three bands or whatever, it was it, we felt that right away. In fact, I believe it was in Manchester. I could be getting that wrong. I am a lead singer after all, so don't, you'll have to fact check me. But I believe it was in Manchester, where that was the first time we actually experienced some type of like fandemonium. We were so at the time, we were opening band, kind of we're on the beginnings of everything, so there wasn't a whole lot of people that knew who we were. And so we would go out in between each act and like go to the merch booth and meet people and just be out in the public, just kind of like selling our CDs. And we went out there for the first time in the UK, and it was like we got mobbed. We couldn't move. We're getting grabbed. People are trying to take my jacket. We were in a tug of war with my little brother because he was getting like further down in the crowd. They were
You
just
realize
taking
that's
him
just
away.
Manchester.
Oh yeah, right. Well, so and but we had no idea, and the security people at the venue were like, "Please don't do that again. Like, just stay backstage." We're like, "Really? Oh my
Wow.
God!" Like, people, no, it was awesome because we're like, "Jesus, I guess they really like us here. We should come back." So and then since then, it's just been such an incredible community. We have met so many fans that come to every show, including like 8 shows in a row, in the UK, and it's just amazing. Yeah, so we're very grateful for it.
It's one thing about UK fans, isn't it? They're very rabid. Once we attach onto a band, we are passionate about it. We really are.
Yes. Yeah, once we get you, we can't get rid of you. That's the it's really great. It's something very special and something that isn't lost on us, living in the US. And believe me, I love my country, and I love our fans here, but it's definitely a different animal. And like I said, it means something coming to the UK.
Yeah, absolutely. I can imagine so. Yeah. Obviously, Wembley Arena, going back to that particular show, you talked about playing lower down the bill. You've done Wembley lower down the bill to finally headline it. When that came through, when that notification came through that it was happening, what was the immediate reaction?
Oh my God, it was like seriously, like, and then because we had booked the show, and then it went on sale, and we were just kind of like crossing our fingers, like, I hope people are going to come to the show because they booked us, and now it's almost sold out, and we still, we're not playing there till December 9th, so it's a great feeling. But again, it was something that we just never thought would happen to us, and so turns out that you never run out of dreams, and we just keep crossing some stuff off of our bucket list, but can you imagine? So I'm already practicing my hello Wembley, hello Wembley, when I get up on stage. So it's got to be a really good one. So
Yeah, what's the real thing to think about? I've not even thought about that, as something that's an art need to think about it, but it is iconic from that point onwards, isn't it?
it's very true.
Yeah, I'm going to knowingly but unintentionally make us both feel quite old now because we're about the same
Good.
age. It's been just over a quarter of the century that the band has been going, since you and RJ started things. Did you always have an ambition to want to make it this far, or was this something that you just never dreamed would happen?
There's a difference between believing that you're capable of great things and great things are able to happen to you. And then that being a reality. I think that we always thought we had something special. I was just having this conversation with the guys because I remember being very adamant that we had something special and that we have the potential to take it as far as we want to. Now, that being said, I had no idea how far we were going to take it. So I had no idea that people were going to like it or not that that really mattered. I think that in a lot of ways, in those early years, I would be very, I remember being very like, how do I put this? I guess prideful, you know, of what we do. And I remember like even I would never even try to compare us to other people because I'd be like, no, we have a thing. And as long as we keep doing this thing, something is bound to happen. And so I think we've just kind of kept that mentality for the last, you know, over 20 years now. Just seeing how far we can take it further. You know, it's like, okay, we did this, like, same thing. Okay, cool. We're playing Wembley. What's next? You know? And what else can we do? It's almost become this like fun game because it's still it's we're grateful and we know we've worked hard to get here, but it's also kind of fun to be like, all right, well, what else can we do? What other weird positions can we put ourselves in that maybe we can make through? Like, okay, we lived through that. Now what else can we live through? So it's a great way to have it, and I love my guys so much. It's always been the four of us against the world. Little bro is in the band, and so you know, obviously there's family, but you know, these boys know me better than most of my blood family, and we've been through a lot together, and nobody will have this journey but us. And so these moments where we're able to kind of have these firsts together still, you know, and like, oh, can you believe it? Can you believe we're here? It's I don't know, it's the best feeling in the world, doing what you love with the people that you love.
Absolutely, absolutely. You mentioned there, you always think about the next thing. What is the next thing though? Now you've ticked Wembley. Well, now you're about to tick Wembley, let's say. What's next?
I still would like to have Hail Force One. I want to have my own plane, because the TSA thing is getting old. Yeah, I'd like to roll right up. Like, I don't have a record, guys. Like, just let me through. I'm a very good kid. But yeah, I mean, there's that. I mean, there's still so many things. You know, there's a lot, still a lot of countries that we've never been to. We've never been to Africa.
Okay.
You know, and so there's that, and like, I don't know, there's just like there, you, I feel like you keep ticking things off the bucket list and then you keep adding things on the bottom of it, so it never really gets completed. You know.
Absolutely, yeah. One of the things that gets talked about with Halestorm, whenever I have conversations with people, I hear conversations about where are the next festival headliners, things like that. Halestorm is one of the bands that generally gets part, mentioned in that conversation. Is that something that's very much an ambition for you? Are you working towards that, or just you'll take it if it comes?
I think that we're always working towards something. I think that it's about preparation for us. Whereas if we're prepared for for whenever the door opens, then we'll go through it, you know, kind of thing. And a lot of times, even if we're not prepared, we go through the door anyway. I think that that's part of that's part of
That's
our
rock and
mission
roll.
statement. It's part of it. I feel like it's more situations like that than ever. Or it's the opposite, where you feel like you're prepared for a certain situation, and then that's not the thing that happens. Now it's this whole other area that you were not prepared for. And so in a lot of ways, it's kind of the same thing that we do live every night, where it's like we don't use tracks, there's no click, it's the four of us that get up there and play. And so it's kind of like every night you walk out on stage and it's like you're jumping out of an airplane and hoping that the parachute opens, you know, which is the best feeling in the world. So I feel like we like to, like I said, say yes to adventure, and the weirder the better. And because we just want to learn something about ourselves. So yeah, I don't know. We're both prepared and also accepting for whatever comes.
Lizzie, I could ask you a ton of questions. There's so much that I'd love to cover with
I
you. I
know we could go
point.
on all day.
But yeah.
You're delightful. You're delightful as always, Corey.
Thank you very much. You've got to rush off, but I do have one question that I can't not ask. There was an interview
Uh-oh.
In the summer that said you were heading into the no, it's not one of those questions, don't worry. You said you were heading in to do some writing sessions in September.
Yes.
Have those happened? Is new music in the works?
Yeah, I think we're always working on new music, but we've actually kind of started to buckle down and really kind of write with a purpose, as to whatever we want to, you know, kind of put out in the world next. It's kind of an exciting time because, I feel like even since the last record, you know, even beyond Back from the Dead, I feel like we're, kind of shedding our skin in a way, that's kind of beautiful, where we all kind of feel like different people, than who we were when we were writing the last record. So it's time for whatever that next chapter is. So it's very exciting. I've been writing in a lot of subjects that I haven't necessarily like touched on before, and been kind of exploring those things. And I've become even more of a serial eavesdropper. I will be sitting at a pub or something, and I will kind of zone out. And it's amazing the conversations you hear other people talking about. And so sometimes those leach their way into the songs. But yeah, we'll probably have something by next year.
Fantastic. That's it. Lizzie, I'll let you go to your next interview. But thanks so much for taking the time. It's been a pleasure having you on the show.
Of course, darling. Thank you so much for taking the time.